Troy Kearns, real estate investor, bringing it to you from my Las Vegas studio. And today I'm going to talk about one of my most exciting topics that I've ever talked about. Today I'm going to get into the top 10 real estate investors in the United States of America. And the reason that you need to watch this video in its entirety is you need to have people to look up to, people to model yourself after, and you need to know how they became rich, how they made their money, and how you can become the next person on the Forbes 10 list of the most richest real estate investors of all time. So let's get into it. Number 10 is a guy named as Jeff Sutton. Jeff Sutton is a New York billionaire, okay? He has $2.8 billion worth of real estate, and it's concentrated in New York City, and he concentrates on retail storefronts. Jeff Sutton is the ultimate real estate investor who goes for high-end luxury areas, and he's always in the best locations. And if you didn't know, Jeff Sutton is the founder of Wharton Properties, and Wharton Properties owns properties all over New York City. He owns properties on 5th Avenue, Times Square, 34th Street, just to name a few. Number 9 is Jerry Speyer. He's the chairman of Tishman Speyer, and he's worth $3.1 billion. His company has developed over 152 million square feet of real estate, including skyscrapers in iconic cities like New York, London, Berlin, Chicago, and others. He also redeveloped several iconic properties like New York's Rockefeller Center and the Chrysler Building. So some big flips there. Number 8 is Leonard Stern. And let me tell you about old Leonard Stern. Leonard Stern got his start in the pet supply business, and he was in the pet supply business for about 7 years until he purchased a warehouse in New Jersey. His company, Hartz Mountain Industries, owns over 260 properties, and that's comprised of over 45 million square feet of office, industrial, retail, all across the board in New York City, New Jersey, and the surrounding areas. Basically, he buys any good deal in New York City, New Jersey, doesn't matter. He's doing all types of uses all over the place. So you might be asking, like, why are most of these rich real estate guys in New York? The price of real estate is super high in New York. That's why if you've made it to the big leagues, I always say Madison Avenue or Fifth Place Avenue, okay? You're always referring to the highest price location in the United States, which is New York City. If we didn't say what Leonard Stern's worth, it's $4.2 billion. Leonard Stern, the guy who started with a pet business and ends up owning so many properties all around the place. Real estate, real estate, real estate. Number 7 is John A. Sobrato and family. He started selling houses in California while he was in college. He later worked on developing real estate industrial complexes and then started his own company. He named that company the Sobrato Organization. Founded in 1979. Currently, he owns 7 million square feet of office space, mainly all the way through California, including 6,700 apartment units. That just goes to show you, concentrate and buy everything. Number 6 is Sheldon Solow, but you know what is not so low? His net worth. His net worth is $4.4 billion. That ain't so low, is it? Well, Sheldon Solow is a major gambler. He bet his entire net worth on one project. In 1972, he made a huge gamble. He bet all of his entire net worth on building one property. That building was 9 West 57th Street in New York City. It's a 50-story office complex that he developed. That 50-story office building that he built on 57th Street has unobstructed views of Central Park, making it one of the most desirable properties in all of New York City. In 2016, the property appraised for $3.4 billion, making it one of the most expensive properties in all of New York City and the world. Number five is Igor Olenicoff. Igor is worth $4.5 billion. For those of you who think you got it tough, Igor immigrated from the Soviet Union when he was 15 years old and built his wealth from nothing. Igor's investments are concentrated in the state of California. He owns 8 million square feet of office space and over 15,000 residential units. So those of you who think office is dead, I got news for you. It ain't dead. Number four is Sam Zell, and Sam Zell is worth $5.6 billion. Sam Zell's a hustler, okay? He started hawking Playboy magazines, and then he started flipping properties. He started flipping 15 properties, then he went and flipped to 4,000 properties, okay? That means he refurbished them and he sold them for a profit. Kind of like what I do now. I'm actually getting inspired hearing myself talk about his story. Sam Zell founded a private firm called the Equity Group in 1969. This group invests in several different industries, including real estate. Sam Zell is basically the forefather of real estate investment trusts, okay? He's basically the one that taught everybody how to pull your money out of real estate by selling it to people as a stock. One of the things that Sam Zell is known for doing famously is he sold his building to Blackstone Investments in 2007, right before it crashed. So he knows how to time the market and he knows how to make the most amount of money. And if you want to make something happen, then you should subscribe to the channel right now, hit the like button, hit the notification button, because what's going to happen by doing that is you're going to send our whole freaking channel into the moon. Send it to the moon, hit the like button, comment below, let us know what we're doing, good, bad, or ugly. This is probably one of my favorite guys to talk about, Stephen Ross, okay? Stephen Ross is worth $7.6 billion. He owns the Miami Dolphins. He bought them from Wayne Huizenga. Stephen Ross is a major New York developer. He actually went to the University of Michigan, famously just recently designed the Hudson Yards. He's a genius. And one of the things that most people don't know about him is that he owns more affordable housing than anybody else on the planet. He got his start in business, and he started by figuring out how to turn real estate into a big business. And what he has done since then is, he bought the Miami Dolphins, he bought the stadium that the Miami Dolphins play in, he bought more real estate down in Florida, and he owns a ton of real estate in New York, and he owns a ton of real estate in Miami and Florida, and he owns more affordable housing than anybody in the United States that I'm aware of. He's actually somebody who I very much admire and look up to, and he's someone I know very much about. I followed his story very closely, and he's someone that I think that you should look up to. All right, number two is a name I have never heard of. It's Sun Hongbin. All of his investments are pretty much outside of the United States. His company is China Holdings, and he owns more investments in China than anybody I know. He's one of China's largest real estate developers, and he focuses on designing large to medium-sized residential developments. Sunac is constantly developing and acquiring other smaller companies, but they are growing big, and they are just riding on China's tremendous growth. He just recently bought Wanda Group's holding for $9.3 billion. And for those of you who are keeping track, it's the second largest real estate deal in China's history. Donald Bad Boy Bren. No, Donald Bren. He's worth $17 billion. He's our number one. Good job, Donald. Way to go, buddy. You're a rich dude. You're someone that we look up to. 17 billion buckaroos is a hard thing to accomplish, okay? So we're gonna give you the old voila. So Donald Bren is America's real estate baron. When he was working as a real estate agent, he invested in a company that bought 115 acres in Southern California. He owns a 97% stake in Manhattan's Metlife Building. And if, for those of you guys who don't know what that building is, it's on the end of Park Avenue. You can see it from everywhere. Big building. His empire includes 550 office spaces and 220 apartment buildings. He owns 550 office buildings and he owns 125 apartment buildings. So for those of you guys who are like, man, I'm never gonna get there, I just want you to realize a lot of these guys started as different things and they just started accumulating and trading up and buying more stuff and bigger stuff. stuff, and the next thing you know, they're filthy rich. It's because they traded in, they used the tax laws, and they bought bigger, better stuff in higher price locations, but they started with a step, one small step, which you can start with today. The first step you should take is subscribing to our channel. The second step you should take is write down your goals. The third step you should take is hit the notification button. The fourth step you should take is make a plan to take action. And take action today by sharing this video with a friend. Peace.